हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास। इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द डिफरेंट फीचर्स ऑफ ऑडिटिंग, डिफरेंट फंक्शंस ऑफ ऑडिटिंग, डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टर्म्स अकाउंटिंग एंड ऑडिटिंग, देन इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ ऑडिटिंग इन द बिजनेस, देन एडवांटेजेस एंड लिमिटेशंस ऑफ द ऑडिटिंग प्रोसेस इन द बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। Right, so in today's class we'll understand what are the different types of auditing. Okay, see, audit is what? An audit is an examination of accounting records undertaken with a view to establish whether they correctly or completely reflect the transactions to which they purport to relate. It means what? Auditing is what? Is an verification of books of accounts and vouchers of a business. That is, accounting is a process of checking of data, statements, records, operations and performances of an enterprise or of an organization for a stated purpose. The whatever documents they provide to the auditor, he has to go through it, he has to verify it, he has to check it whether they correctly and completely reflect the transactions which are recorded in the books of accounts. Right? So, in any auditing situation, the auditor perceives and recognizes what? The propositions. Propositions here what? Propositions are here documents. Okay? Documents which are before him, which are submitted to him for the verification, right? So that is known as auditing process, right? As it will enable, that is, auditing will enable the auditor. Why he goes through the auditing process? Why the organization go through the auditing process? Because it enable the auditor to satisfy himself that the whatever documents is presented, or you can say here document can be the balance sheet or the transactions which are recorded in the books of account. Okay, these documents are properly drawn up, right? So as to give a true and fair view of what? The stated affairs of the business and whether the profit and loss account. See, balance sheet is not the only financial statement. Financial statement includes what? Profit and loss account statement as well as the balance sheet statement, right? So along with the balance sheet, he has to verify whether the profit and loss account gives a true and fair view of the profit and loss for the financial period or not. According to the best of his information and explanations given to him, he has to verify these balance sheet and the profit and loss account. Right? So, as shown by the books, for which he has to collect what? Evidences. He need to evaluate it. Here evidence can be what? Vouchers. Right? And he has to evaluate it. Whether the evidence which he has collected is matching with the transactions which he has recorded in the books of accounts or not. And the same, okay, the same whatever he evaluates, on the basis he formulates what? His judgment, and he gives his opinion and suggestions to improve the business activities. And if he is not satisfied, see, whatever these processes have explained, this will be when he satisfies himself that the whatever transactions and the evidences are given, they are matching. Then only he can give his opinions and suggestions for the improvements of the business activities. If he is not satisfied, then he has to explain that in what respect he is not satisfied. Okay, that is the work of what? Auditor. Now, how these auditing process, this is what auditing process, how auditor will conduct this process, auditing process. Now this auditing or audit, or you can say auditing process, okay, is classified into different types. See, the requirement of getting the books of accounts audited became mandatory due to what? Legislation. That is, Companies Act 2013 has made it compulsory of getting the books of accounts audited by each and every type of business. Right? So, because of this, the process increases for the auditing. Right? So, they have to classify it on the basis of different factors. The nature and scope of audit vary due to what? Various factors. So, on the basis of those factors, auditing will be classified. Then, what are those factors? There are n number of factors which classifies the auditing, like size of organization, strength of internal control system, legal requirements, and so on. But for your syllabus, auditing is classified on the basis of three factors. What are those three factors? Based on ownership, based on time, based on objectives. So, on the basis of factor of ownership, on the basis of factor of time, and on the basis of time of objectives, auditing is classified into different types. Then what are these sub-classifications? We'll understand one by one. So, the auditing is classified on the basis of ownership into six types. Now, we'll understand the ownership. See, business organization will be having different options with it when the owner plans to start the business. What are the different types of ownership? Sole trading concern, proprietorship. Sole trading concern is nothing but what? Proprietorship, then partnership, then joint stock company, then trust, then cooperative societies, right? So there are different types of ownership. So on the basis of this factor, auditing is classified into different types. Then what are those types? Audit of proprietorship, which is nothing but audit of sole trading concern, then audit of partnership, audit of companies, audit of trust, audit of accounts of cooperative societies, then lastly government audit. Next factor is on the basis of time, auditing is classified into four types. First one is interim audit, continuous audit. For continuous audit, we have some advantages and disadvantages that we'll understand at the time of explaining the term. Okay, so at present, we'll understand what are the different classification on the basis of the factor time. So the first classification is, or the first type is interim audit, continuous audit, final audit, and balance sheet audit. Okay, next factor is objectives. So on the basis of objective factor, auditing is classified into five types. First one is internal audit, cost audit, secretarial audit, independent audit, and tax audit. So these classifications we'll understand one by one in next class. Okay, thank you.